crack sealing is the root of all evil as far as pavement maintenance goes. The crack, once a crack opens and water gets down into the base of the pavement, that's when problems start to appear. I always try to encourage an agency, if they have money to spend on any one type of maintenance, to make it crack sealing. That's the one thing that they get the most bang for their buck. There are different types of cracks. There's transverse cracks, which run from the side of the pavement towards the middle or all the way across. There's longitudinal cracks, which run the length of the pavement, either next to the center line or about the middle of the lane. Reflective cracking happens when an overlay has been put down and the cracks below it have not been treated, and those cracks reflect up through the new pavement and reform. Alligator cracking develops because the crack sealing process wasn't done early in the pavement's life. Once the pavement gets to this point, there's really nothing you can do. The pavement is too far gone. You can crack seal the cracks and buy some time, but eventually you have to tear all that out and start fresh. When is the best time to crack seal? As far as the sealant manufacturers go, the best time to crack seal is either in the spring or the fall. The reason being is pavements move, as we all know, they expand and contract. They're kind of midway between their minimum and maximum movement. And so you actually get a better shot of effectively sealing it then. Crack preparation, there's really a couple of different techniques to go by. Routing, saw cutting, where you're actually creating a reservoir for the sealant to have room to adhere to the sidewalls of the crack. Routing and saw cutting can add up to 40% to the life of the seal job. There's blow and go, where you just basically blow out the debris and the dirt and just apply the sealant. The application methods of an oil jacketed machine usually includes a hose and a wand, which could be either non-heated or heated. The direct fire unit, you usually end up using what we call a pour pot or a bander, where you pour the material into it and apply it in the crack that way. When applying the sealant, one of the critical things to watch out for is putting too much sealant on the surface or leaving too much on the surface. If you're doing an overband situation, you really need to either have a sealant disc on your equipment or have somebody follow with a squeegee to make sure that sealant's nice and tight against the pavement. The main reason for this is if you ever overlay that area, if there's a bunch of excess sealant on the surface, when that hot mix hits that sealant, it livens up, remelts it. When the roller comes along and hits that spot, it actually slips because it becomes slick due to the melted sealant underneath it, which actually creates a little bump in the pavement. All materials or equipment discussed are readily available at any of our GemSeal one-stop shop locations.